So you couldn't even get to speak at a council unless you came bearing wampum. First, you had to have strings to signify who you were. They were like your credentials, your ID. People would recognize a certain string and say, oh yeah, he's the right speaker. He's the right person for that nation. They would take the belts and deliver a speech holding up the belt. And they would make sure everybody can see the belt. They would hold it different ways so that everybody sees the visual while they're delivering a speech. But it was up to the nation to receive it or accept it or reject it. If they rejected it, they may go up, pick up that belt, repeat the speech that was made, and symbolically throw it on the ground, or perhaps throw it right in the face of the chief that presented it. It was all just dramatic gestures to make sure everybody knew that belt had been rejected.
So wampum was present because then it was the belief that it was one of the highest things that had, if I would say, a deep spiritual significance to it. So if you were holding the wampum and you were making a pledge, then it was supposed to be serious, that you really meant that.
Ça a forgé notre structure politique, notre société, ces objets-là. Puis ça, je crois qu'il faut déterrer ça. Il faut mieux les comprendre. Puis je trouve que ça m'inspire de la fierté, ces objets-là.
When we discover wampum belts, and we have to reconnect them to their original context as historians. And sometimes we can do that, and sometimes we can't. Sometimes there's a little document trail, because it's hard because so many of them left our possession. Were bought up by collectors in the 1800s and the early 1900s, and that chain of command, chain of possession left, and sometimes a story that went with a belt that had been memorized generation after generation gets lost.
Historical fact that is showing up here and there, Rick Hill has said in his presentation, he says we all have to be cultural detectives. We have to question how the message is put out there and by whom and for what purpose.
Il n'y a plus personne, ou presque, pour transmettre le message qui était véhiculé à travers ces objets-là. C'est une des raisons pour lesquelles les wampum aujourd'hui sont pour beaucoup des objets importants, mais des objets matériels.
Chaque nation devrait être en mesure de gérer ses propres ceintures. Puis même si aujourd'hui on a oublié certains messages que ces ceintures-là portaient, si on les oublie, on les oublie, mais si on peut s'en servir pour lui donner d'autres paroles, mettre une autre parole à ces ceintures-là, pourquoi pas, là? C'est des objets qui ont passé à travers le temps. C'est des objets remplis de spiritualité, puis de croyance, puis de diplomatie, que quand même la diplomatie avant était pas mal plus au sérieux qu'elle peut l'être aujourd'hui, là.
Aucun wampum n'a appartenu à un individu. Il s'agit d'un objet collectif. Donc, qui en serait le détenteur au moment d'un rapatriement? Bien, la nation. Les droits qu'on obtient ou qui sont reconnus dans n'importe quelle cause ne sont pas des droits individuels. Ce seront à tout coup des droits collectifs.
This belt here is one that we repatriated in Akwesasne about 15 years ago or more, by my predecessor who held the job before me. It was a lot of negotiation with the New York State Museum in Albany, New York. And this belt was proven to have come from Akwesasne. The documentation was pretty clear about that. And so the museum repatriated the belt to us. We had a big ceremony for it. We took it across the St. Lawrence River in canoes. And then we put it in the Akwesasne Museum where it is today. So anybody can go in and see a belt that I believe originates in the 1760, the conquest, as they call it. The fall of Montreal, the fall of New France in the Seven Years' War.
Well, I know Hilda has been trying very, very hard since 2005 to have our own heritage center here so that we could have a potential to bring them back home. That would be, you know, mm-hmm. a wish, a big wish that we would have so that our people, especially the young have to learn that we had heroes. That we had heroes throughout time, and they weren't to be put down.
When you start to fully understand and appreciate the power that is in these wampums, wampum strings, wampum belts, he said they're going to talk to you. At first, I didn't really know what he meant. But when you take the time to make a loom, and you're focusing, and then these deeper thoughts come in mind.
J'en ai créé des ceintures de wampum, là, tu sais, j'en ai créé deux, là, tu sais, originales, pour des contextes spéciaux, tu sais, que je connaissais pourquoi l'événement, pourquoi la ceinture allait être faite. Fait que dans ce temps-là, tu rentres dans un monde qui, OK, tu fais ça pour telle raison, fait que je vais le fabriquer comme ça, tu vas faire mon dessin, c'est ça que ça va représenter.
Cette idée des wampum, ça peut prendre, selon le travail qui est là, ça peut prendre retracer les formes des symboles qui se trouvent dans les wampums. Ça peut être par cette idée des lanières. J'utilise souvent des fils dans des œuvres suspendues que je fais. Les fils touchent la terre et montent jusqu'au plafond. Pour moi, c'est cette idée de continuité. C'est à ça que je fais référence dans mes installations suspendues. C'est encore la connexion qui existe entre terre et ciel et entre les personnes.
Ce qu'un wampum incarne, ces valeurs-là n'ont jamais disparu. Ils se sont juste transformés puis ont pris d'autres apparences. Ont été supportés par d'autres principes, d'autres objets, d'autres valeurs. Mais le message des wampum, lui, il est éternel. Le wampum, c'est un objet. Hein? Ce n'est pas un système d'écriture. Sans la parole, sans la langue, ce n'est qu'un objet.
Sometimes when I get presentations in the schools and I talk to little kids, I introduce the whole topic as the seashells that saved the world. You know, that these beads were made from something as mundane as what washes ashore, but had that incredible power to unite people, to get them to speak about peace instead of war and conflict. And it healed the hard feelings caused by war so that people could get together with their former enemy and make a lasting peace. So there's so much tied up in wampum that's why it's so important for people to appreciate and understand. It's not just an artifact. It was the interface between the colonists and the native. It made it possible for the countries that emerged to exist. Had it just been nonstop war and disease and destruction like a lot of people portray, we wouldn't be here today. Wampum allowed us to carve out a place in the future for Native people. So I think it's something to celebrate.
But in this land, on Turtle Island, if we can get this knowledge to resurrect up, then there'll be a hope because there's going to be no more wars, there'll be environmental stewardship, we're going to think about the future generations, and we're going to be happy and sing. Because life is so great and so beautiful. Ho-wee-oh, hey, hey, wee-oh, hey, hey, oh. Oui, oh, 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 oui, oh, hey, hey, oh, hey, oh, oui, oh, oh, oui, oh, hey, hi, we are, we are, we are, we oh, hey, hey, we oh, hey, hey, yo, ho, we oh, ho, oh, we oh, hey, hey, ah, hey, oh, we oh, how we oh, hey, ah, ya, we are, we are, you we. Yeah.